Captain's personal log, stardate 44908.2. I have been ordered to a Priority 1 conference with Admiral Morgan at Starbase 317. The Admiral refused to say precisely what this conference will be about, but he hinted that it might involve a bigger command. To have a bigger ship, to have a real starship, to have an ambassador-class vessel with those sleek lines, or perhaps a nebula-class ship with more photons than a Cardassian can shield against, or, dare I say it, a galaxy-class vessel to be flagship. Oh, this could be the best day of my life! So, Admiral, I'm here. What's this all about?
I presume you know about the Melkot situation?
Melkot?
The Melkot are a reclusive race that are possessed of tremendous psychic powers. A century ago, the Federation had some positive contacts with the Melkot, but those soured and we now have no relations at all.
So?
Since the most recent Borg attacks, Starfleet has charged me to develop a psychic weapon. I believe the Melkot have such a weapon, and you must contact them at all costs, even if it means violating the Prime Directive.
Violating the... Wait a minute. These orders aren't from Starfleet, are they?
Well, not exactly.
Then no way! I could be court-martialed for this.
Well, if that's the way you feel.
It is.
I guess I'll just have to find someone else to captain the USS Trafalgar.
The what? That's a new galaxy-class ship!
Yes, well, I was going to recommend you to captain it. But if you aren't willing to take a few small risks for me, I'm not going to put my name on the line to get you a bigger ship.
I deserve a bigger ship. I need a bigger ship. Damn it, I'd do anything to get a bigger ship!
And that's exactly what I was counting on.
Now, where have I heard of that planet before?
It's where your old ship went, 100 years ago. Remember?
Malkosha. Now, that isn't the planet with the gorgeous android babes.
Nope.
Was it the one with all those Nazis?
No! It's where disembodied head creatures made you relive the Battle of the OK Corral in Earth's ancient west.
Oh yeah! This is like what happened on my old ship!
Of course!
course it is. I just said...
There was this planet, and it was like a bad set from some ancient Western movie. And none of the physical laws apply, so... We had to have a mind meld.
Mr. Benson, you told us the same story the last time we mentioned we were on our way to this planet, just 15 minutes ago.
Yes, but...
Captain, the planet is hailing us.
Put it on screen, Lieutenant.
Aye.
Federation vessel, you have violated the space of the Melkot. We consider your trespasses here a violation of our sovereign right to independent development.
Melkot Ambassador, I am under orders to re-establish contact between our two peoples at any cost.
The Melkot warn you that if you persist, we will use our psychic powers to force you to relive the worst day of your life.
Captain, no! We should turn back!
Lieutenant Martin, may I remind you that our orders are clear. Besides, Admiral Morgan warned me that there may be something like this. It's only a test to determine our intentions.
Leave this space, Captain, or suffer the consequences.
Do your worst.
Very well, if you will not appease us.
Habit Rail Unit number 57, please.
Replicating Habit Rail for your hamster again. Sinclair must have you pretty upset.
Ooh, that Sinclair. Brown-nosing everyone. He has Captain Hayes so snowed.
But Admiral De Jong, she's fairly smart. I'm sure she'll see right through him.
I hope so. This diplomatic initiative with the Tholians is of key importance. If I make a good impression, it could really help my career. I may even be promoted to captain.
Yeah, well, shouldn't you be getting that habit trail back to Stripe?
Oh, yeah.
That I can stalk them for quite some time. The humans have a great amount of ritual associated with meetings of this type. I could BS them about peace initiatives and cultural exchanges for a week or so.
It could take that long.
Their computer is most uncooperative. It refuses to give us the dimensional stabilizing technology.
We have tried and tried to convince it.
We need time to fabricate the necessary voice prints. Very well, but hurry!
Computer! Computer, this is Chief Engineer Lepowski. Transfer all data readouts concerning the top secret Federation Dimensional Stabilizer Project to this station.
Unable to comply.
You there, Tholian! What are you doing at this station?
We are merely attempting to learn more about your wonderful culture.
Yes, if there is to be cultural exchange, we must exchange...
Exchange culture!
Nothing classified.
Oh, no.
But I thought I heard you saying something about dimensional stabilizing technology.
You have such a lovely culture.
Don't try to change the subject. We see right through your ruse.
We would never try to insult your intelligence in that way.
Never!
Oh, what is that lovely thing you are holding?
This? Why, it's just some habit trail for my hamster.
What is this thing, Hamster?
Oh, hamsters, well...
Look, it's just a furry little creature that runs around in circles.
Ooh, wondrous.
We have never heard of such a marvelous wonder.
Well, perhaps you'd like to come to my quarters sometime and see it.
Oh, yes.
There is nothing that we would like better than to see your hamster.
We love hamsters.
We should tell our ambassador about this wonderful opportunity.
Immediately.
Goodbye.
Wow, I had no idea Tholians were so interested in hamsters.
Yeah, learn something new every day.
You know, this could really make the difference for me in these negotiations.
So, Celeste thinks she can take this Tholian's strange obsession with hamsters and use it to her advantage as a reception. Well, two can play at that game.
But she has the hamsters and we don't. How do you know we're gonna win?
Well, I have an idea. We must beam the hamster from Celeste's quarters immediately. And then we will present it to the ambassador first.
You are a genius. A genius.
I know.
I have a little surprise for you. What the? Stolen! Those sneaky Tholians. They said they were going off to talk to their ambassador, but instead they were off on a mad plot to steal my hamster.
Geez, they sure are obsessed with hamsters.
Why, I oughta...
We can't just call them on it. We can use this to our advantage in the negotiations.
You're right. If we can catch those Tholians in possession of my hamster...
Right.
This reception will be a triumph. When I present this hamster to the Tholian ambassador, I will go down in history as the architect of the Tholian Federation Alliance. Well, it is only a matter of time.
I wonder what's for dinner.
No. Celeb is coming? I hope she did not find out about this reception. You hide the hamster, and I'll go get rid of her.
Dining room.
None of your beeswax.
There's not some sort of formal reception for the Tholian ambassador or something, is there?
No. No, now go away.
Fine. Well, I have important business of my own to attend to. Come on, Shiz. They've got to be around here somewhere.
Whew. That was close. What did you do with the hamster?
I put it in there.
Sacre bleu! In the soup! Get it out! Get it out! 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 Get it out! Out of the soup!
And this will perhaps usher in a new era of cooperation between our two peoples.
Yes, Admiral de Jonga! I hope that we will be able to discuss the arrangements for this treaty at length!
Well, here we are. Ambassador Yaga, Admiral Dijon. This is Second Officer Clayton Sinclair, Lieutenant Valerie Constantine. But my first officer doesn't seem to be here. Sinclair, did you inform her of this dinner as I requested?
I'm not certain on this, huh? It's just like her. She's a slacker.
Most disappointing. Please be seated.
Chief Engineer Lakowski.
The jig is up, Tholian. We're on to you.
Oh, Commander!
We want you!
Never mind the excuses.
Would this be a good time to see the hamster?
Huh? I think you know the answer to that question.
Oh, dear.
Wait! Commander, what is that behind you? It looks like a hamster!
Stripe?
We've got to get out of here!
Oh, dear!
Hurry! Hurry!
What about the data?
Never mind that! Let's get the ambassador! The troubles between the Federation and the Tholian Assembly have been overemphasized in recent years, Admiral. Our joint interest in the dangerous space surrounding the interphase region has led to certain conflicts, certain disputes over technology that would allow both sides to peacefully explore the region. But by nature, we're a punctual people. We believe in our punctuality. Live by it. Feel it. I may even say that we are renowned throughout the galaxy for our punctuality. If Starfleet and the Federation can but learn to respect this one point, I believe that a peaceful coexistence can be produced. Trade, yes! Peace, yes! Harmony and accord, yes! Trade, peace, harmony and accord, on time! On time, gentlemen!
The captain!
Ambassador! They found us out!
We must leave immediately!
Soda!
He's dead, Admiral. Soup poisoning.
Very well. What? The soup is poisoned? What Federation treachery is this? The negotiations are all finished!
But Mr. Ambassador, we can straighten this out. There's no evidence of poisoning.
Your own captain is lying there dead as a doorknob on the table, Admiral. We will beam back to our own ship immediately!
Well, that's just great. What a time to keel over, Hayes. Well, I suppose that wraps it up for me.
Admiral? I believe the USS Alibut will be in need of a new captain, no?
Ah, yes, it looks that way. Executive officer to the reception room. Executive officer, respond, please.
Well, it is like I said, Admiral. She's a slacker. Probably in the holodeck. As always.
Ah, yes. Well, I suppose then I have no alternative but to give command of the Halibut to you, Captain Sinclair.
Wake up! Wake up, Celeste!
Huh?
Wake up!
What?
Ah, you are awake.
I can't believe that you are concerned about my welfare.
I'm not. I just wanted to be the first to tell you. Your precious hamster, Stripe, is dead. And I have been made captain of the Alibut.
No!
Are you all right, Captain? How do you feel?
That was the worst day of my life.
Our intent, Captain Thalev, has been to test your intentions, to see whether your species has become worthy to contact us. The last Starfleet captain that attempted to contact us was a self-centered, overbearing, egotistical creature with no thoughts save for his own ship and career. We see that you are no different. There shall be no contact. You shall not have our psychic weapon.
Please?
No. Now go away.
No new ship.
Oh, Captain, you just relived the worst day of your life for nothing at all.
Not quite. I think that now I can safely say that that day, so many years ago, was my life's second worst day.
Thank you.